Android 10 is finally out, and we just got it pushed to our Google Pixel 3a, which Google kindly gave us a few months ago. We've been testing out the 3a for a 6 months later review, but I thought it'd be useful to go over, one, how to get the latest version of Android on your Android device, especially right now if it's a Pixel, and then second, I want to go over the top two features of Android 10, which in my book are the gesture navigation as well as dark theme. So let's dive in. All right, first, how do you get the latest version of Android on your Android device? Now, when Google releases the latest version of Android, they always go to the Pixel phones first because Google makes Pixel phones, so it's very easy for Google to roll them out to those phones. Now, if you have an Android device from other devices like Huawei, Samsung, Nokia, etc., what happens is Google releases Android 10, then it's up to your device manufacturer as well as sometimes your cell carrier to give their stamp of approval, and they'll do add-ons and customize it and add crap onto it, and then it's released to you. If you want the purest version of Android, how Google intended it to be used, that's really what the Pixel phone is all about. Okay, so enough about selling you on Pixel phones. What you want to do is you want to go to Settings, scroll down till you see System, then click Advanced, and then click System Update. Now, if you don't see a system update, don't panic. Make sure you click that button in the bottom right-hand corner that says check for update. Now, if it checks for an update and no update is available, hang tight. Android 10 was actually launched yesterday, but we didn't get an update pushed to our Google Pixel 3a until about 7 o'clock the day after. So once the update is available, all you have to do is click to install, go through the menus and things that will pop up. For us, it took about 5 to 10 minutes to actually install Android 10. Again, it's got to actually download the update, install it on the phone, and then restart the phone. Now, when the phone actually restarted, you can tell right away that you are getting a new version of Android. Google's logo for Android actually is slightly tweaked on the loading screen for Android 10. If you're interested more about that, Google actually did a blog post about it. They've like tweaked the color for the Android mascot and the way the mascot is incorporated into the Android logo and a couple other things. Anyways, if you're interested about that, I'll link that blog post that Google put out in the video description below. Now, when we actually started up our Google Pixel 3a, one of the most shocking things with Android 10 right off the bat for me was it looked exactly like Android 9. Like, maybe the font looked slightly different. There wasn't any pop-up or anything that said, hey, welcome to Android 10. Here are the top 5 things that you should check out that you can now do. Like, nothing. And gesture navigation and dark mode weren't even things that were turned on by default. There was nothing pointing you to where they are. So that was something that I definitely thought is lacking overall in the Android experience, is being able to guide users, at least on the version that Google puts on the Pixel phones, is making it easy to guide users through new features of the phone. To go ahead and switch to gesture navigation on Android 10, you have to go into your settings. So let's go ahead and go to Settings. We're going to go again to System and then Gestures, and then click System Navigation. And this will bring you to a page that shows you you now have 3 options. You have the 3-button navigation. That's the good old fashioned Android way to navigate around a phone. You have 2-button navigation. This is what was previously on Android 9. And then you have the new gesture navigation. Now, gesture navigation basically brings Android a little bit more up to par with some of the gestures that are currently on iOS. So the biggest one for me, at least, so let's say we're just on a screen here, is back swipe. Notice there's no more back button. The only thing I wish they had that I feel like you have on iOS for certain things is, like, say I went back here, but I'm like, oh, I didn't mean to do that. I can't swipe it forward. It's Android isn't set up the way iOS is, where it's like a series of cards that are like stacked on each other. So if you swipe one this way, you can swipe it back like on web pages. Yeah, you can't really do that here. So how do you go home now? How do you go to the home screen? Well, it's actually a little bit simpler than it was before. You just swipe up. Now, a couple other things. One thing I really liked about Android 9 was the Favorites app dock. And the way you get to that is actually very similar. You just swipe up, hold about 1/3 of the screen. You get a little vibrate click from your phone, and there you go. How do you get to the app drawer? Well, it's the exact same way as you would before. Also notice how snappy getting to the app drawer is. I mean, that's, I can't tell if they've done any performance improvements on the back end of the OS here, but even on the Pixel 3a, like, the phone feels snappier going from Android 9 to Android 10. It's not a huge improvement, but it's not to say the phone was slow to begin with. I'm just saying it feels snappier after upgrading. All right, now, last thing. Let's talk about the Google Assistant, right? In two-button navigation, you have that center button, you'd click it, and that would trigger the Google Assistant. Well, in gesture navigation, there is no more center button, right? It's just screen, and then it goes to bezel. Basically, what they've implemented is something akin to hot corners, right? You just swipe diagonally from the corner of the screen, and that will trigger the Google Assistant. All right, let's talk about our second feature with Android 10, and that is dark theme. How do you get dark theme enabled? Well, we're gonna need to go to settings again. This time we're gonna go to display, and then you'll see that dark theme should be right underneath wallpaper or right around it. Go ahead and check dark theme, and that will enable dark theme for your phone. Now you may get a pop-up that says, hey, dark theme's available for like these apps, but some apps don't support it yet. Currently, I think Chrome and Gmail, and maybe there's like one other actual Google app, still doesn't support dark theme yet. That support is coming, and those apps are supposed to launch with dark theme later on in September. But for now, apps like Google Calendar, those types of apps, they work with dark theme. Now, let's say though that you wanna toggle dark theme on and off, but you don't wanna have to go into settings every time to do it. Well, luckily for you, there's actually a dark theme quick control. So you just swipe down from the top like you normally do, go to your quick settings here, scroll down, you'll see that you have additional things that you can drag in. Tap and hold and then drag dark theme in, place it where you want it, and then either swipe back or hit that back arrow at the top of edit, and now dark theme is in your quick setting controls. You can easily tap, oh, no more dark theme, oh, but I want dark theme back. Tap it again, now you have dark theme. All right. So that's just a quick rundown of how to get Android 10 on your Android device, especially if you have a Pixel phone, as well as my take on the top two features of Android 10. Again, I really like gestures. Dark theme's cool. It'll be even cooler when more apps support it natively. But if you like this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button below and subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more Pixel and Android related videos like this one. Well, thanks again so much for watching. For 6 months later, I'm Josh Tedder.